Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Alhamdulillahi rabbil alamin. Wassalatu wassalamu ala ashrafil mursalin, khatamal anbiya'i wa imamil mursalin, wa ala alihi wa sahbihi ajma'in. Rabbi shrah li sadri wa yassir li amri wahlul 'uqdatam min lisani yafqahu qawli, amma ba'd. We begin by praising Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and we send peace and blessings to Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. My brothers and sisters, inshallah today I want to get a bit creative. I want to take us all back in time, inshallah. I want us to all get imaginative. Let's start picturing this. Paint a picture in your mind, do whatever you have to do. I want to take us back, inshallah ta'ala, to the time of Musa alayhi salam. And we know Bani Israel at the time, they were the most oppressed people. You know, they were living under Fir'aun in Egypt, and they were the most oppressed people at the time. And then Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He sent them a messenger, one of the mightiest of messengers, Musa alayhi salam. And Musa alayhi salam, he came with miracles. And Bani Israel, he was the only savior. You know, Musa alayhi salam, he through the power and qudrat of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, he could turn a stick into a snake. Because at his time, magic was at a peak. So Allah gave him the power to turn a stick into a snake. And at the time when Musa alayhi salam promised the Bani Israel the holy land, he told them to follow him, and then they ended up at an ocean. Bani Israel lost hope. And then Musa alayhi salam, it was ordered by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to strike the ocean, and the ocean split. And then they all ran through, and Fir'aun followed. And then after they got through, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala commanded the ocean to crash upon Fir'aun and his army, and they all died. You know, I want you to put yourself in this very picture. Imagine you were there. Imagine you witnessed such a miracle from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. How strong would your iman be? How strong would your faith be? How much belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would you have? Would you have any doubt in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? Would you have any doubt in Musa alayhi salam? Not a chance. Isa alayhi salam. At the time of Isa alayhi salam, health and medicine was at a peak. You know, at this time it was at a peak. Through Allah's power subhanahu wa ta'ala, he gave Isa alayhi salam, he gave him the power to cure the blind, to bring people back from the dead by the will of Allah. You know, Isa alayhi salam also had to show miracles to his people. You know, but put yourself at that time, and imagine you lived at that time. How strong would your faith be? How much belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would you have? Would you have any doubt in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? The reality is we wouldn't. Not a chance. Because we see miracles. These miracles happen before our very eyes. You know, there will be no chance on earth that we'll have any doubt in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. You know, but these miracles, my brothers and sisters, these miracles, they happened. They're not happening today, and they're not going to happen again, you know. But for us today, do we have anything? Do we have any miracles? You know, the reality is, we do. Today, the Ummah of Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is the only nation that has a miracle which withstands itself to the end of time. The only nation. You know, we have the Quran. Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam had Quran revealed to him 1400 years ago. A man who couldn't read or write. Quran was revealed to him and it was memorized. It was passed on to Sahaba. It was a book that was implemented. It was a way of life. A book that is full of historical miracles, scientific miracles, grammatical miracles, the list goes on. This very book here, my brothers and sisters, is our miracle. It is a miracle that we have before us today. It's a book that we all have at home. But how strong is our faith? And how strong is our iman? How much belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala do we have today? The reality is not much. The difference between us and the people before us is that our miracle will withstand itself to the end of time. Our miracle is stronger, yet their faith was stronger. Our faith is weaker. Why? Do we have that attachment with the Quran? Where has our love for Quran gone? Sahaba at the time of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, they didn't change their life through Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Their life changed through the words of Allah. They were from the worst of people and they became the best of people. They shared Islam with Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. They were the reason that Islam is reached the East and the West today through Quran. But the reality is we don't have Quran in our lives. And it's the greatest miracles that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has ever bestowed upon any nation, ever. But our connection with the Quran is weak. The reality is we don't have a connection. You know, the Shaykh read an ayah previously and he said, when Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he complains to Allah and he says to Allah, Ya Allah, my nation has taken this book, they deserted this book. You know, they've left this book on their shelves, they only read it from Ramadan to Ramadan, if that, they neglected this book, they left the book, they had no attachment with this book. And you know what the sad thing is, my brothers? This book is our only way to success in dunya and akhirah. It's the only way and it's the path for our eternal success. But for some reason we choose different paths and different avenues and think that Jannah is granted. Wallahi, we're wrong, man. If we don't have this connection with the Quran in our life, really, really, we're out of loss. You know, just earlier today, I'll share a story with you, inshallah. Earlier today, maybe about 4 p.m., myself and a few brothers, we visited an elderly brother who's on his deathbed at a nursing home. He was on his deathbed, and you can look at him and you can see he's feeling sakaratul maut. He's there, he's very, very close. And you know, I looked at the brother and one thing struck me. I looked by his side and the Quran was there. You ask yourself, why is the Quran there? Is that a coincidence? Is it there just because there's family from putting it there? Or is it there because Muslims understand the power and the magnificence of the Quran? Really, why was the Quran there? We understand how valuable the Quran is, but we don't want to do anything about it. We understand that there is no other way but Quran for us to earn Jannah, but really we don't want to do anything about it. When I saw this book by this man's side, it was a reality check. For me, it didn't feel like I went to visit this man so I can visit him and make him comfortable. For me, it was a reality check and a slap in the face that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala dragged me there, along with the brothers, to show us what we lack in our life. Allah dragged us there to show us that in this period, this is the only thing that's going to save you. But where is our connection? And really, it was very disheartening. It was scary. That's the reality. And I speak about myself before anyone else. It was scary. You know, we read Quran for the ones who do, and we don't even know what's in Quran. Why? Allah has made it very easy. It's a book that's going to be there to the end of time, whether we like it or not. It's a book that's not only meant for the Arabs, but Allah says to Muhammad that he was sent to mankind. He was sent to everyone. No one has an excuse. But without a connection with Quran, we have nothing. You know, you picture yourself, you picture your ending without Quran. Ask yourself where you're going to be without Quran in your life. You know, come that time when that man, when you're on your deathbed, where are you going to be? Are you guaranteed Jannah? Really, really, we don't have an excuse. It's been about 3 weeks or whatnot in Ramadan, and really, this is the month of Quran. You know, inshallah ta'ala, we've created a connection with Quran, but if we haven't, it's never too late. Let's pick up our act, let's get closer to the Quran. Let's implement Quran in our life. Let's understand Quran. You know, we make time for everything in dunya. We make time for everything. But we neglect the Quran. You know, we walk past the Quran at home, we look at it and we just keep going. It picks up more dirt than we pick it up at, you know, that day or whatever. It's very sad. Wallah, I share this from my heart and inshallah it hits your heart too, because it was very, very touching when I saw that man. And I really can't get it out of my mind. You know, just the thought of seeing the Quran by his side, it meant something to me. And inshallah, it's a story that you can all relate to and understand the importance and the greatness of Quran. You know, he didn't have family there. He didn't have his kids, siblings, nobody. The only thing that was by his side was the word of Allah. The only thing. And you know what was even freakier? The man's eyes were closed. When the brothers went down and we began to read Surah Yasin, he opened his eyes. And we were there for about 10 minutes before. He didn't open his eyes once. My brothers, this is a reality check for all of us, man. It is a reality check for all of us. Where do we stand in our love with the Quran? Yeah, because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, He says, if you want to hear me talk to you, you read the Quran. And if you want to talk to me, you pray. We need to be prepared to make sacrifice and get connection with Quran. You know, after Ramadan, if we don't know how to read the Quran, we have to start. There's no excuses. Really, there is no excuses. At the end of the day, you're working for yourself. All you're doing is you're guaranteeing yourself Jannah. But without Quran, it's very hard to say, and I'm sorry to say, it's going to be hard, man. It's going to be hard. You know, alhamdulillah, the youth center which is praying right now, they run Quran classes. It's not very hard. We're all around, you know. Inquire about it. After Ramadan, I'm very sure that they're doing testings and the classes begin again. Get yourself into the habit of reading Quran, make Quran part of your daily life, and start to understand Quran so you can implement Quran. Because Quran is the only way. It is your straight path. So just once again, my brothers, I really, really urge all of us, and beginning with myself, to create a connection with Quran and start to live the Quran and understand what Quran was sent to you. Understand that this great miracle that's been sent to you by Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala is your only way. Is your only way. Inshallah ta'ala, may Allah make us from amongst those who listen in here and act upon what they listen in here. Subhanakallahumma wa bihamdik, nashhadu an la ilaha illa anta, astaghfiruka wa natubu ilayk.